Welcome everyone. The title of this lecture is Entropy of a Discrete Memoryless Source. This is an outline of the lecture. First, we find the entropy of a discrete memoryless source. Then we define the nth order extension of a discrete memoryless information source. Then we evaluate the first, second, and nth order entropies of the discrete memoryless source. Finally, we find the relationship between the entropy per symbol and the entropy per message. The source under consideration is a discrete time information source. Discrete, which means that the set of possible symbols in S is finite and countable. The source is discrete in time, meaning that the source generates one symbol from the set S equals A1, A2, up to A sub M each time unit. The output of the source in the first time unit is a random variable X1. The output in the second time interval is also another random variable, and so on. There are two models which describe the discrete time information source. The first model is a discrete memoryless model. In this model, it's assumed that the random variable XT is independent of the previous random variables X1, X2, up to XT minus 1. In the second model, it's assumed that the random variable XT depends on previous values assumed by the random variable X1, X2, up to XT minus 1. Mathematically, for a discrete memoryless source, the probability that the random variable XT takes on a given value XT given the previous random variables X1, X2, up to XT minus 1, this conditional probability equals just the probability that the random variable XT takes on the value XT, which means that these previous values do not affect the value taken by the random variable at time T. This means that these set of random variables are independent, and as such, the probability mass function of these random variables are time invariant. As for sources with memory, past values taken by the random variables x1, x2, up to xt minus 1 will affect the value assumed by the random variable at time t. In this case, the random variables x1, x2, up to xt are no longer independent, but dependent random variables. For our discrete time information source, we define a probability distribution, meaning that symbol A1 will take some probability P1, symbol A2 will take a probability P2, and so on. The sum of all probabilities is, of course, equals to 1. In a previous lecture, we defined the information content of each symbol generated by the source by this formula, I of S sub M equal log base 2, 1 over P sub M in bits. This means that symbol A1 carries an amount of information, log base 2, 1 over P1. Symbol A2 carries this amount of information, log base 2, 1 over P2. And symbol AM carries this amount of information, log base 2, 1 over P sub M. The source entropy, or the average amount of information per symbol, is defined as the expected value of the information symbol S1 occurs with probability P1 and carries an amount of information log base 2 1 over P1. Symbol S2 occurs with probability P2 and carries this amount of information log base 2 1 over P2. So the amount of information carried by each symbol is a random variable, and we can find the expected value or the average amount of this random variable using this relationship. That is, the expected value or the average amount of information can be obtained by multiplying the amount of information for each symbol by the corresponding probability P sub I, and we can sum over all values P sub M. So the entropy of the source is minus P sub I log base 2 P sub I, and the summation is carried out between 1 and M. The summation is carried out over all symbols taken by the information source. As we have said in a previous lecture, the entropy has two interpretations. In the first, entropy is regarded as the average amount of information in the source, and in the second interpretation, it's regarded as a measure of the uncertainty in the source. Extension of information sources. Consider a source S with symbol probability distribution P of AI equal PI for I equals 1, 2, up to M. The nth order extension of the source denoted S superscript N consists of messages of N symbols drawn from S. Any message M sub J equals X1, X2, up to Xn, and the number of possible messages runs between 1 and m to the power n. The message consists of n symbols. Instead of focusing on one single symbol generated by the source, now we consider messages of length n, and we need to study the entropy per message. The probability of any message M sub J, this is a typical message of n symbols, the probability of this message equals the probability of X1, X2, up to Xn, equals the probability of X1, probability of X2 given X1, probability of X3 given X1 and X2, up to the probability that Xn given X1, X2, up to Xn minus 1. For a discrete memoryless source, the random variables X1, X2, up to Xn are independent, and therefore the probability of the joint event equals the product of the probabilities. Therefore, the probability of message MJ equals the probability of X1 times the probability of X2 times the probability of Xn. This is an example of a discrete time information source. The source emits two symbols, 0 and 1. We may look at this typical realization of the source, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1. This is the first order extension of the source. That is, we just focus on a message of length 1. For a second order extension, the message consists of 2 consecutive digits, and so the possible messages are 00, 01, 10, and 11. Here, the message consists of 2 symbols. This is for the second order extension. For the first order extension, the message consists only of 1 symbol. That is to say, the output of the source consists, in this case, of messages. Each message is composed of n symbols. Example, consider a discrete memoryless source S which emits either a 1 or a 0 with the following probabilities. Probability of 0 equal 0.8, probability of 1 equal 0.2. Find the entropy of the first order extension and the entropy of the second order extension. For the first order extension, we can compute the entropy using the formula H equals minus 0.8 log 0.8 minus 0.2 log 0.2, and this equals 0.72 bits per symbol. For the second order extension, these are the possible messages 00, 01, 10, and 11. The probability of this message 00 is 0.8 times 0.8, since this is a discrete memoryless source, that is the random variable x1 and the random variable x2 are independent, and therefore the probability of the joint event 00 is the product of the probabilities of 0.8 and 0.8. The result is 0.64. The other message 01 has a probability of the probability of 0 times the probability of 1, 0.8, 1.2. The probability is 0.16. For this message 10, the probability is also 0.8 times 0.2 equals 0.16. And finally, for this fourth message, the probability is 0.2 times 0.2 equals 0.04. Now we have 4 possible messages, and we can compute the average amount of information per message, or the entropy of the extended source, as minus 0.64 log 0.64 minus 0.16 log 0.16 minus 0.16 log 0.16 minus 0.04 log 0.04, and the result is 1.44 bits per message. We recognize that the entropy per message, which is 1.44, is twice the entropy per symbol, which is 0.72. So for this discrete memoryless source, the entropy per message is twice the entropy per symbol, which means also that the uncertainty in one message, in a message composed of 2 symbols, is twice the uncertainty in a message which consists of just 1 symbol. Now we consider this theorem. If S is a discrete memoryless source, then the entropy of the nth order extension equals n times the entropy of the first order extension. We provide a sketch of the proof for the case when n equals to 2. That is, we consider a message which is composed of two symbols. We denote these two symbols as x0 and x1. x0, of course, is the random variable taken in the first time slot, and x1 is a random variable which is taken in the second time slot. x0 can take any one of the impossible values assumed by the source, and x1 also can take any one of the impossible values assumed by the source. So these are typical realizations of the random variables x0 and x1. Due to the independence between the random variables x0 and x1, we can say that the probability of a message consisting of two symbols x0 and x1 is the probability of x0 times the probability of x1. We can find the entropy of the extended source using our definition. So the entropy of the second order extension equals minus summation over all values taken by x0, summation over all values taken by x1 of a probability of x0, x1 log probability of x0, x1. Actually, for the nth order extension, since the number of possible messages is m to the power n, in order to find the entropy, we have to sum over all possible messages, and this is the probability of a message log the probability of that message, and this is the probability of any message m sub j equals the probability of x1, x2, up to xn. This is our message of size n. We come back to this summation. Since x0 and x1 are independent, the probability of the joint event is the product of the probabilities. So we have probability of x0 times the probability of x1 log the probability of x0, probability of x1. Then we realize that log the product of two quantities is the sum of the log, which means that this summation becomes two summations. In the first summation, we have probability of x0, probability of x1, log the first term, which is log p of x0. In the second term, again, we have p of x0, p of x1, and log p of x1. We notice that we have p of x0, log p of x0, and so we sum over x0 of p of x0, log p of x0, and we have this summation over x1. In the second term, we have p of x1, log p of x1, with a summation over x1, and then we have this summation over x0. We recall that the sum of all probabilities is 1, so this summation is 1, meaning that the first term will be simply minus p of x0, log p of x0. The second term, also this term is 1, so we have minus p of x1, log p of x1. The first term is simply the entropy of the source p of x0, log p of x0 with this minus sign. And the second term is also the entropy of the source p of x1, log p of x1. This is also h of x. Therefore, the entropy of the second order extension equals the sum of the entropies in the first symbol and in the second symbol, and therefore the average amount of information per message is twice the average amount of information per symbol. In conclusion, for an nth order extension source, a superscript n of a discrete memoryless source, the probability a message m sub j equals the probability of this sequence x1, x2, up to xn equal the product of the probabilities, probability of x1, probability of x2, probability of xn, which leads to the important result that the entropy of the nth order extension equals n times the entropy per symbol, which can also be rewritten as the entropy per symbol equals the entropy per message divided by n. It turns out that the entropy per symbol for a discrete memoryless source is independent of n. For a discrete memoryless source, we can say that the entropy per symbol is simply the summation minus pi log pi. The summation is carried out over all symbols assumed by the source. As for the nth order extension, we consider messages of length n symbols, and we found that the entropy per message is n times the entropy per symbol, which means that this message contains an amount of information on the average n times the amount of information carried by one individual symbol. This concludes this lecture.